This is one from the vault!
One from the vault.
Oh my gosh, one about, supposedly about Nick Jonas. Which, or no, excuse me, Joe Jonas.
If it was about Nick Jonas.
That'd be surprise!
Now that would be like, why didn't we talk about this sooner?
Has anyone dated multiple Jonas brothers? It's hard to keep track of those Joe bros because for people with had purity rings, they really got around. Welcome back to 2 Gay Mads. It's Matt Palmer.
And it's Matt Steele.
And guys, this morning, out of nowhere, Taylor dropped her second pre-release from the vault track from her upcoming Taylor's version of Fearless, which I believe is being released this Friday. It has a million tracks.
Yes.
Including all the tracks in the original, all the tracks on the deluxe that was released back in 2009, I bet, and additional tracks, like 5 or 6 new tracks that we haven't even heard before. I'm so ready.
I know, and we were talking about how we're very excited because now we're going to have a deluxe version of the album.
Yes.
Where the bonus tracks from the original deluxe version of the album are not at the front
right.
end of the album. They're in the back of the album where they should be.
Exactly. It's just like when you're introducing people to Fearless, it's like you need to start at the top.
Start with Fearless.
Yes.
Start with Fearless and then work your way down.
It won't make sense if you start with like Jump and Fall or
yeah,
whatever.
Yeah, and we like
fun.
Jump and Fall.
Oh, it's a great song.
And of course, acoustic version of like piano version
forever
of Forever.
Always. A classic.
Yes.
But
the rest of those bonus tracks. Mm.
Well, and the thing is, we also listened to You're All Over Me, I believe was the first
yes.
from the vault track that came out. And I thought it was very nice.
Yes.
Mary Morris sounds great. It's a nice background vocal. But was kind of like, yeah, I get why this didn't make the album back then. But like, good song. I'm glad to be hearing it. I assumed this was going to be a similar situation. And it was the morning and we all have things to do. I'm working in the morning. So we didn't have a chance to create a reaction video to this. But even I wasn't thinking we would because I was like, oh, it'll probably be like as good as You All Over Me, and I see why I didn't make the album, blah, blah, blah. I listened to it, and I was like, wait,
like,
this is serious.
Okay, I come home from going to the grocery store at
yes.
night, and Matt Palmer's folding his laundry, and he's just like, new Taylor song's great, we're doing a reaction video.
Yes,
and
we
so I was like,
are.
Okay.
I stopped listening, because I listened to it like 2 or 3 times, so I was like, I need to stop listening, so that when I react to it, I don't remember exactly how every lyric goes. Lyrically, melodically, and bridge-wise, it's like...
Oh, another good bridge.
Taylor. It's just like Taylor was so in her element writing this album, and clearly she had an embarrassment of riches, but like, this song could have been something on that album. I mean, I guess we are hitting the like... Forever and Always really does give you the Joe Jonas broke up with me and I'm furious
mm-hmm.
vibe mm-hmm. to a T, and like we would never want to replace that, but like if we wanted to expand upon it, this song would do so.
Which of course we would love to do.
I mean,
like, let's expand upon it 12 years later?
I mean,
13 years
and
later?
And it also was funny that she like put it out. And then Joe Jonas's now wife, like, Instagram it, and Instagram story it, and she was like, you know what? It's not a bop. And I'm sure her husband's sitting there like, really, bitch? Like, you're gonna be promoting this song, tearing me to shreds from 12 years ago. They're all friends now. I'm sure she texted them like, hey, I know I sent your baby a present, but also I'm releasing a song that's gonna be shading your husband. I hope that's okay. Bye!
I love
it's great.
That.
It's great.
And at this point, Taylor realizes now, you know what? Our relationship lasted, like, how long?
Exactly.
Like a month.
And
I'm
were
very
children.
Much over it. Yes.
They were babies. Like, I feel like she was, what, 17, 18 when this
yeah.
was happening? So... They were children. I'm sure they're very much over
but
it.
But she was a mature child. She was 17 writing like one of the best albums of
oh,
the decade where
really
every
was.
Song was pretty much perfect.
So this is Mr. Perfectly Fine.
Okay.
And I'm very excited to listen to it once again for Matt Steele to hear it one time for the first time.
Is there a lyric video that I can like look at the lyrics on the
I
screen
imagine so.
Like,
I just listened
it.
On Spotify when I heard it.
Maybe they didn't put it on because they felt like there were too many albums and songs in that vein on Fearless.
I mean, yeah, you're going to give excuses until you hear the song.
All right.
Be mad.
All right.
Taylor Swift, Mr. Perfectly Fine.
Ooh, I love the tux.
I love the tux.
Looks like Joe Jonas.
That's the thing, we have to remember Joe Jonas and those show bros wore a lot of suits back in the day. That'll come up.
Man, she never forgets a detail, does
really
she?
Does,
she just puts it all in there. From the vault.
Vault.
I miss the country, Taylor.
I know. It's got a little twang to it.
We're gonna hear that Pennsylvania Southern accent. Okay. Mr. Here to Stay. He wasn't.
Nope. Mr. Looked me in the eye and told
me you would never go away. Oh. He lied.
Everything
was right. It wasn't. Mr. I've been waiting for you all my life. Yes.
Melody.
All of these are lies.
Oh.
I love this melody.
I told you! I know! She's like, I'm using that line in a different song.
Oh, this brings me back to Fearless days.
I know! I told you!
Mr. Never Told Me Why. Ooh. Well, he dated him for such a short period of time.
But he also did it over the phone.
That's true.
Oh. Mm. When she went on Ellen and was like, Joe Jonas broke up with me. It was great. Oh, Camilla Bow. Didn't marry her. Oh. I mean, she digs, doesn't she? To break in my eyes,
to always have the right place at the right time. Oh my god.
Baby, I told you! To casually
cool. In the name of being honest.
Yes. Oh, what a song.
I mean. What's the bridge?
Wait for it, babe. It's happening.
Gosh. Hurry up, bridge. Hurry up. Get here. Oh.
Love that.
Gotta repeat it. Oh, of course you were. Okay.
Yes.
Oh, I love that.
Oh, goodbye, excuse me.
It's not gonna be the last time, but.
I know. It's one of those things where it's like, girl, wait till you meet Jake Gyllenhaal. If you think your heart's broken, my God.
You said you'd never go away.
Yes, he did. I guess he did.
He said he'd be there.
I mean.
How was that not?
I know.
Like, we could have afforded to put that on Fearless.
Yes! People. Just one extra song.
One extra song that's amazing. I and know. I mean, she already won Album of the Year. The Grammys very deservedly. But, like, it would have been even more deserving.
I know.
Man, I wonder what the decision-making process was for why
that
wasn't on
there. I guess, like, thematically, is it saying anything different than Forever and Always? Like, I feel like there's there's a few songs near the end of the album that are very, like, everyone in my family loved you. You did everything right. And then you were gone.
And all those songs are great.
I know. Hey, and I am with you. I think this we should have heard this earlier. Maybe it wasn't finished. Maybe it wasn't as polished as this Taylor's version is now.
Yes. Maybe she like did a little rewriting. And was like, oh, you know, we can make this a little better. But like, if that is rewriting, she really brought her mindset back into Fearless era, because that just is fearless. Like, that is the sound of fearless. It just brought me back, and I'm just like, yes, yes, yes.
I don't imagine it was rewritten, but I do imagine it was probably polished to be of the same quality. Maybe the demo version wasn't as polished and wonderful, but that melody and that lyric,
yes,
it is so singable. It is so fun. I think it is a great one. I'm so happy we get to hear it. Like, that's the best part of this whole From the Vault things. Like, what Speak Now songs are from the vault? You know how I feel about Speak Now.
Wait, the Speak Now vault is gonna be a great vault. That's gonna be the vault. Let's see if we can break into that.
I mean, I don't know what the release dates of these are gonna be, what the tempo, the cadence we are with releasing them. The sooner the better for me.
It's gonna be a long year.
Hey!
If it's like, she's like doing it all in a couple months apart each. I'm exhausted already.
I know! But
you know what? She's been exhausting us for so long. She's by dropping a bunch of stuff every couple months. So why not keep going, Taylor?
Is the Taylor's version of Fearless going to debut at number one? Like, is this album about to debut at number one again?
I mean, why not?
Stranger things have happened. Damn! Good for her.
Why didn't she, like, re-release this one first?
I know. I would have put this over definitely some of the deluxe tracks.
Yeah. Okay, well, I can't wait to see what all those other tracks sound like.
I
can't wait to listen, like, re-listen to Fearless again.
I know, me neither. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to listen to our podcast. It comes out every Monday. It's called Two Gay Mats, TWO. You can find it on your favorite podcatcher. Also, go to patreon.com/twogaymats to support us and get extra bonus content. I want to give shout-outs definitely to Adam Parnell and Jesse and Richard and Montana, and to all of you for watching, because we love you so much.
Bye, guys.
Yes, we'll be back soon with more Two Gay Mats. Bye.